Hello, and welcome back to Dungeon Mastering Videos. I'm your host and resident nerd watcher, Nicholas DiPietropa. You may be enjoying, as I am, my colleague Jana's blog posts on the main site, where she's been putting together hypothetical fights between Dungeons & Dragons' biggest baddies. You can see Orcus and Tiamat, for example, hypothetically duking it out. But whenever I read those pieces, a question springs into my head. What are the heroes doing? Traditionally in D&D, we have two factions, us and them, good guys and bad guys. The bad guys are all unified and doing something evil, and the good guys are all unified and need to stop them. But the question is, why are bad guys working together? Evil is often chaotic and almost always selfish. Why should those people have better teamworking skills than your average corporation, which has bickering, infighting, and different divisions who don't like each other? Perhaps there are different factions within an evil organization, or different evil organizations. They're all working towards the same or similar goals, but they might not like each other, or they might outright hate each other. This can really throw your party for a loop. They might not necessarily know who's doing which evil thing. You can drop hints like having different symbols of their allegiance, or having letters referring to different leaders. Then the party needs to ask themselves, are these factions working together? Do they hate each other? Could they be united against the heroes? What can the heroes do to drive them apart? Or could the enemy of my enemy become my friend? Or is he just another enemy? Often, if you leave players in the dark, they make a lot of assumptions about the bad guys, and they act off that faulty intelligence, which can lead to some great misunderstandings and roleplay moments. Or the heroes can act very cleverly and drive apart the bad guys. Or if the heroes aren't so clever, they may end up with two forces working together, much stronger against them. Not only evil often has splinter groups, but the heroes can too. It's a roleplay cliche where a hero comes into a tyranny and encounters a band of resistance fighters that they join and really lead to victory in overthrowing the tyrant. But why is that always the case? A lot of times, heroes won't want to share the glory with other groups. There could be many people working against an evil faction, but will they always want to work together? Sometimes they might not know each other. Other times they may not necessarily get along. There could be a history between different members of the group that causes them to clash. Or, one of the most interesting ones, is if there's another group out there working towards the same goal, but using different methods. Methods that the players might find unsavory. Perhaps there is a resistance group working against an evil tyrant, but the resistance group isn't above torturing anyone who they suspect to be helping the tyrant. Any spies, or believed spies, are killed immediately upon accusation. Would your players work with a group like that? Could they depose the evil king on their own? These are a lot of roleplay questions that they will need to answer for themselves in character. And this can cause some great moments of drama in your group. What if they don't want to work for the group? What are they going to do about this band of resistance fighters? Can they really fight these people who should be their allies? Would they fight to the death? If they imprison them, who would they turn them over to? They can't hand them over to the evil king. Factions cause a lot of complications, but lead to a lot of roleplay, diplomacy, treachery, subterfuge, double agents, and backstabbing. They can really add a lot to your game and go beyond the very narrow scope of us versus them. It can just be all of us versus all of them, or us and them and them and them and them and them and them, and so on. There may be groups out there your players don't even know about that can lead to major complications down the road. It's all the fun of playing around with the factions of your campaign. That's Dungeon Mastering Video. Until next time, good luck and good rolling.